The good conduct of righteousness and the bad conduct is wickedness. Inability to discern leaves them open to being tossed and thrown, like I say, left and right and center, and carried with every kind of doctrine. There will become a time, Ephesians chapter 4 verse 14 says, like a wave of sea driven and tossed by the wind, double-minded man, unstable in all his way. James 1 verse 6 to 8. So you got to discern, you got to grow, you got to be mature, you got to stand firm, so that in time of crisis you know the right and the wrong. Amen? So do you have the ability to discern? Can you apply principle to specific situation, or to do your require clear, thou shalt not, to determine something is wrong? So, are you able to recognize when the doctrine is true to God's words, or are you depending on someone else to spoon feed you? You got to be like the Bereans, my brothers and sisters in Christ. You got to start searching the scriptures. You got to start knowing God. You got to meditate on the word. It got to help you. You got to think. You got to think of all these years, what is happening in your life. What did you see and why it happened? Are you part of it? Are you part of the situation? Are you part of the problem? Are you part of the solution? Many are part of the problem and not the solution. Today we got to discern. Today we got to recognize. Today we got not to be spent a spoon feed. We got to be filled, to take up your hands and lead you, to tell you what is the right and the wrong, what is truth and what is error. Amen. So we got to today, my brothers and sisters in Christ, your time spent here will be blessed. Amen. There are certainty, the indicator of spiritual immaturity. Amen?
Amen.
How immaturity people behave. Behavior in a carnal way. Example, possession, strife, envy, and jealousy. In 1 Corinthians 3, 1-4. But in your present text, we focus our attention on presented here. The thou hearing, the inability to teach others, a dire of fear. So therefore, beloved ones, since you know beforehand, beware lest that you will fall from your own steadfastness, being led away with the error of wicked, but grow in the grace and knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. To him be the glory both now and forever. In 2 Peter 3 and 8. In James chapter 1, pray and God will give it to you. Do not repeat from primary 1, you fail and you go over and over again. You've got to grow. You've got to grow and lead others to God.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
I believe if everyone in this place are filled spiritually, next Sunday, I believe the whole church will be packed.
Amen.
Amen. I believe the whole church will be packed. So my summary, the Bible says maturity is the discernment, not just the basic truth. Okay? And your heart produce a crop.
Amen.
Your heart that produce love. Simple faith should lead to a fruitful life. Diligence by studying the word of God will help you. Maturity means having the right attitude. Amen?
Amen.
So let's today check ourselves. Where is our spiritual level? If not, then we got to ask God. The Bible says in Ephesians chapter 1, 11 verse 12, time of your birth and where you would live, I determine all this. And Psalm 139 verse 14 says, you are fearfully and wonderfully made by God. Psalm 71 verse 6 says, and you brought forth on the day you were born. So I knew you even you were conceived. You were conceived. The Bible says, I knew you even before you were conceived. Jeremiah chapter 1 verse 4-5. And Psalm 139 verse 3 says, I am familiar with all your ways. God is familiar with all our ways. So today, don't take the word of God lightly. Change. my brothers and sisters in Christ, change your ways. Change your ways that other two might come to know Christ Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
And last but not least, Exodus chapter 19 verse 5 says, "For you are my treasured possession." And Jeremiah 33:3 says, "And I want to show you great and marvelous things."
Amen. Amen.
How can God show you great and marvelous things if you are not spiritually matured? God wants to show date and time your destiny. I know the destiny, but I want to show you great and marvelous things. So, and then Psalm 37 verse 4 says, "Delight in me and I will give you the heart of your desire."
Amen.
Amen. Delight in God today. Delight in His word. Meditate on His word. Repent and receive the grace of God.
Amen.
Amen. And all these things is possible by the power of the Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
Let's close our eyes. We need the Holy Spirit, my brother. Through the Spirit.